Hello everybody and welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be drifting with Landon, the Fanboys team member, in his 240 with a 5-liter swap in it. So we just got to the track, we loaded up his stuff, drove here, and let's go to the pits, meet up with him, and talk about his car a little bit before we go driving.
This is the girl. It's my 1991 240sx with a 5-liter swap. It's not the greatest thing in the world, but it works. And that's all that matters.
Is there anything done to the 5-liter?
Yeah. Well, it's factory heads. It's got a cam though, and roller rockers, bigger throttle body, and a newer ECU with a MAF. Runs a bit rich, but it runs and does pretty good. MSD ignition box too. Yeah, there's not much else going on other than that.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So that's the engine. What trans does it have?
Not just factory BorgWarner T5.
BorgWarner T5.
Not even the world class, but it's been...
It works, though.
Yeah, it's been whining away all year.
How long have you been driving this car at the track?
All of last year and start of this year so far. I mean, the transmission's been making noise the whole time, so it's only a matter of time, but it's been fine. So.
And this thing looks insane.
Thanks,
so,
man.
What kit is this?
Oh, I wish I could tell you, honestly. I think it's mostly just eBay stuff, you know, painted with the, Fanboys colors. And
the wheels, though.
Yeah, the wheels, they're SSR Vienna Courage.
Real boys right there.
Three pieces.
And then suspension, you got?
Street Dreams coilovers.
Yeah.
VC Works angle kit and subframe bushings. And all adjustable arms in the rear and ISR front tension rods. And everything seems to clear and steers good.
Nice.
It's been solid this whole time. Yeah.
Let's go into the interior and take a look.
Yeah.
We got some NRG seats in here, Nardi wheel, a little bit of custom dash and gauge combo.
I did just do a bunch of interior work to it. It had uglier seats before, but we just got these ones and threw them in. Had the Nardi for a while. No hydro. I like to keep it kind of clean. Cable.
Yeah, I'm surprised you've never ran a hydro at all.
Yeah, no, I've been meaning to. I have one. I just been kind of lay on getting, dual calipers. And it works, and it parks the car and it locks them up when I need them too. So, I don't know. I like the factory look. And
yeah, fair enough.
I don't want the big thing sticking out yet until I need it.
Yeah, cool. Yeah. All right, tell me one thing you love about this car and one thing you hate about it.
One thing I love about this car. Well, it's the car of my dreams. This is what I've always wanted, and I finally have it there.
And you built it yourself 100%. I watched you work on this thing for months.
Yeah, I tore this thing down to nothing. I mean, everything but pull the glass and painted the interior floors. I mean, they're ruined already, but I did everything to this car. Massaged the firewall to get the engine to fit nice, and did my own oil pan, all that kind of stuff. So yeah, I'm stoked on the way it is now. Couldn't be any happier. Could use a little more power. I guess that's the only thing holding me back. I could use another 50 horse or something, but it's really all I need, and at least for my skill level.
Okay, what do you hate about it? One thing.
One thing I hate.
What's the most annoying thing?
My radiator's too small. Yeah, I'm using an SR20 rad.
Right, overheats. Okay.
Yeah, so, I mean, it hasn't gone...
Let's go look at it.
It hasn't, completely overheated yet.
That's an SR20 rad?
Yeah, it is, yeah. I mean, it worked, but I have another rad I'm meaning to swap in, but, as with everyone's own builds, they're never fully happy with it, right?
So, yeah.
After the season, this guy got to do a big re all over again,
Fair enough.
The engine's sitting too high. I want to lower that down,
put
my new rad in, and just get the driveline in better, sitting better. I mean, it's in there nice, and it clears. I mean, it rubs the hood, as you can see.
a little bit. Yeah,
it is too high up, but the big game plan and the biggest thing I hate is pretty much how the engine's sitting in there right now. I did the best I could with what I had, but the second time around, I'm hoping I get it in there a bit more comfy.
Nice. Well, let Landon know in the comments below what you think of his build, and roast him on it.
Yeah. Make sure you hit on the danger pipes in the back.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget about those.
The coffee shooters. All right, buddy, we're going out for our first run of the day.
Oh, I don't know what I'm doing, though.
You don't?
I thought you were driving, man. Yeah, I think I'm getting her dialed a little bit.
I got a little bit of dust in my eyes.
Yeah, me too. That was hairy though, eh?
It was a bit hairy there.
I should have given more room.
A little bit more space for the first couple rounds, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you just got these headers ceramic coated and it's made a huge difference, eh?
Oh yeah, night and day, man.
Crazy.
Yeah. Usually I'd open the hood and it'd just be a freaking oven in there, but
yeah.
I know it's cold out today, but yes. The difference is insane.
How'd you feel?
Good. I just really having a mad at, so I'm gonna pump these guys up a little bit, I think.
You wanna get some sick B-roll of the fucking
Not
truck?
At all, go away.
Okay.
Do you have the truck, man? Do you have DeWalt batteries?
At home.
Cool, man. Cool, man.
Yeah. I have like a half charge one at home.
That's tight, dude.
They're at 52.
Put them up to 60.
All right.
If you may, please.
No, not doing it now. Yeah, into our first issue. Her fan is just like dicked. It sounds really bad. So we're gonna take it off. We're gonna try and fix it. You're all fixed up.
Yay! Thank you.
You're welcome. We got our fan working again. The blade actually came disconnected from the motor, and there was debris inside the motor, so we cleaned it up and got her back together. It would probably help if I could plug this freaking thing in. Eh? Alright, it should work now. Should be good.
Okay, finally we're back out on the track. Fixed Jackson's car.
Yeah.
You guys been driving a little bit. So car's feeling all right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Woo! The car feels good. I don't know. That's a 50-50.
Questionable driver.
Yeah.
horny together, for sure.
You're horny?
Ben and I get horny.
Okay, this is on record, buddy.
Oh, we get horny. I just hope he has enough grip to play for this lap. Because he's on these, like, little 7-inch wheels or whatever, 7-inch wide wheels. They're, like, off a Civic, and it just doesn't work out for him. Like...
Dude, I love crashing into each other. It's fucking dope.
It's all about the hand control.
It is, yeah.
It is. I if anyone's watching this and they're wondering how do I get good at drifting, don't hang on to the steering wheel very hard.
Yeah.
You see what I do is I barely touch the steering wheel and it's all using the throttle.
Yeah. If your car is set up right.
If your car is set up right, you might have to like if it's not, like panic struggle, but if it's set up right, it should do exactly what I just did there, where I just don't even touch the wheel.
Yeah. Just catch it where you want.
Catch it where you want and let go, use the throttle.
That was a 40-mile.
Ben's car doesn't start.
It's never.
Is it maybe your wheel lock? It's probably the horn.
Oh shit!
What? What the fuck
happened? This doesn't happen.
Hey, we fixed Ben's car.
Jane did all the work.
No, say no to the starter. I'm just fixing people's cars today, that's why. I fixed Jacqueline's car, fixed your car. Who's next? But if he stalls it, we're kind of fucked.
I guess that means I could always jump start it, like bump start.
Yeah, you can run start it, yeah.
I hate doing that.
Oh, it's the worst. With a welded dip? Like,
yeah.
Thank you.
dude, that was fuck. Yeah. There's a milestone right there.
Yeah.
Woo!
That was good. My foot is ramping up so bad.
Oh really?
That was intense.
But he's Connor quits at 210. Come on.
Yeah, I'm too hot. One more.
Yeah, that's right. 210's nothing, buddy.
I'm at 210. One more. Man, that was so sick.
Let's try her again, buddy.
Super good day today. Landon drove super good. His car worked really well. There's no real problems. He, I guess he kind of worked those out throughout the last few weeks with ceramic coating his headers. That helped him a ton when it came to heat in his engine bay. You know, it stopped him from overheating and burning up his spark plug wires. So that was super handy for him to have done. And Jacqueline drove really awesome. Her car was doing good too, but we just kind of had a hiccup with her electric fan, but for her radiator. But we kind of just did a little quick track rebuild on that and got her back up and running and back on the track. So stoked we were able to do that for her. And then we got to go out and drive with Quentin Erickson and his white E36 and Ben Voss and his silver E36. And they're both slaying it and getting real tight and tandem-y. So that was exciting. We did have to help Ben fix his car because it stopped as soon as we went to go for a ride with him. It just stopped, didn't want to turn on. So he wasn't getting a key on signal to his starter, so we basically just made that happen with a live 12 volt wire, and his car ran and he just didn't turn it off. So sure he'll get that sorted out soon, but just a really good day of filming and at the track with everyone and having fun, and a lot of new drivers out there, which is cool to see. So I'm stoked to see a lot of people are getting into the scene. Unfortunately, our track is going to be shut down. This will be the last season, but we're hoping to get somewhere else to drive. So we'll keep you posted on that. But if you guys like this type of video, let me know. My car is in need of some work, which we'll be doing soon, so keep tuned. And we will work on my car soon and get out there and drive myself. But if you like these types of videos where my car's down and I get to go out and drive with other people, I'm happy to do them because I had a lot of fun. Thanks everybody for watching. I think that's it for today's video, and we'll catch you next time.